Mafethu, welcome to another exciting episode of The Hangout. This is Channel 260, channel of choice. If it's your first time watching the show, I go by the name Uluwando Wakanjokweni, but I'm never riding solo. Got my call here, Sissy.
Hello.
Asiyaphila, please introduce yourself.
Well, mna igama lam nguZinhlengqeza, and I am your host of The Hangout. And today's show, we are basically bringing everything that is going to be lovely and nice. Mm-hmm. And we're just going to be talking to book authors. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk to fitness trainers. Mm-hmm. We're basically going outside the streets and speaking to the people out mm-hmm. there. And also we have...
Sinama Repa, I'm fair to call him Repa. There's a line that I like. It is zo polishi kamalam, zo shinisi kamalam. And in the villain here, tetangam, but care. Yeah, yeah, zo tazela. He's going to be one of the guests. He's going to be here. I'm going to call him Repa. If you're going to Repa Mugeli, stay tuned, man. He's going to tell us about his career, about his journey. But he's also an engineer, man. That's a very nice thing. But Kembukel, you know how to communicate with us on social media platform. It's The Hangout on Channel 260. But don't change the channel. Don't make bad decisions because we're coming back after this.
And we are back from an air break. Thank you so much for tuning in with us on to this segment. We are going to be basically speaking to an author, someone who is writing stories and also giving us knowledge. And I am talking about the none other than Ubutma Doda Dakuse. Let's welcome him on the show. Welcome, Butkunjani.
Siyaphila seswami nkosi kakhulu ngokundamkela. Hey, ikhona nje landayo engathula lo yiko
yaqonda. But ke
ndinethemba nzaba right.
No, you'll be fine, Budam. So, for the viewers at home, abangakwaziyo, you ungumuntu obhalayo. You write books, you write stories. When did the love for storytelling start?
Olu dumo lika zano dumo, aluphelelanga nje edutyini nasebhizana. Koko lufikelele nakwezinye izithili. Esinye isicelo asifumeneyo silolu hlobo besivela kwisikolo sasemandileni. UZanodumo usamkele ngothakazelelo esi sicelo ekhumbula ubuzondani wayemxelela uba ikhaya lakhe lisemandileni.
Well, I started to fall in love with poetry when I was doing standard 8 ngela xesha lethu sasingenayo o grade 10, yeyibona. And also I realized just after finishing matric, there was one person owandicela into yokuba ndimbhalele icomposition about love, and then ndamenzela 4 beautiful paragraphs. And then oomisi bakhe bamxelela into yoba no, sisandla sikandla kuse esi, awuyibhalanga ngokwakho le. That's when I realized ukuthi oh, okay, italente yam even if andisekho sesikolweni iyarecognizwa, then I should follow this. This is, you know, talent at its purest form. So ndaqala ngolo hlobo.
So with the books onazo apha namhlanje, can you say ikhona iFacebook yakho up?
Ayikho iFacebook yam, ziyi-9 zintle iincwadi zam zizonke.
Yeah.
So zezinye nje ndingaske ndithi into ekhoyo yi-last book qha.
Is it?
Yeah, le uyibambileyo ithi bamfuna efile.
Which one is it?
Ke nantsi ibomvu, ibomvu krwe. Yeyibona masixa inokufa into inobubomvu.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So when we're talking about le ncwadi, which is the current one, what inspired it?
Well, this book was inspired by a number of stories I've read about people, especially abantu abatyholwayo. We've got our own brothers and sisters and cousins abasejele as we speak, and you find ukuthi abantu bakuthi bayakwazi ukubanjwa bengazenzanga izinto ekuthiwa bazenzile. Ezinye zazo zibuhlungu kakhulu, kuthiwa umuntu yi-rapist ahlale for 40 years ejele, 25 years, you know. I was inspired by such. Of course, there is also enye ijele abantu abangafane bayicingele, le yokuba umuntu aphatheke kakubi emsebenzini ngenxa yamayelenqe. So I guess ndibhala ngezi zinto ezinjalo.
So would you say, since we're celebrating the Youth Month, and we know the history behind the 1976, would you say uba the struggle that the older generation experienced has some sort of beneficiary kuwe as umuntu who's writing books now, and awubhali nje izincwadi, but you ubhali incwadi that can cater for any other languages?
Well, that's very controversial from my end, because if you are studying the history of what transpired in 1976, most of our brothers and sisters were fighting totally against Afrikaans. Mna, as a writer, I do not have a problem with any of the languages. Instead, ndikhuthaza la nto kuthiwa yi-multilingualism ne-biliteracy, noba umntu angabhala ngoluphi ulwimi. And ndiyazibuza uba le ke ngeka-1976 How about kuthi kanti bebethelele ukubaleka kwesixhosa? Endani baba jonge Africans, bakhe bami ngeAfrikaans bathi guys, siyatoyitoya sifuna nibhale ngesixhosa. Ndicinga uba ibiza bang 1976 omnandi. Without into kuba ndingene kwipolitics. Anyway, ndingumbhali, I'm not a politician.
Yes. So also coming to uba ngumbhali, would you say that out of all the babies onazo at this moment, ikhona I favorite book yakho apho?
Kunzima into kuba ndibe nayo i-favorite book apho. Because nina njengaba phulaphuli, especially nina njenge TV presenters, yeah, nizawupush i-agenda yale ncwadi nimbuze uba kutheni ethanda le, ndicinga uba ngabantwana bam kamanditshilo uba these are my babies. Imagine ke ndithi hayi ndithanda i-firstborn, i-lastborn ndiyayicaphukela okanye yeyibona laa nto.
Yeah.
Umntana okanye umzali unothando nendlela eyahlukileyo yokulibonisa kumntana ngamnye anaye. Mm. So kuyafana nalapha ezincwadini, kulaa nto uba ziadresa different topics, yabona.
Okay, yeah. So also when it comes to writing, because incwadi e1 has many pages in it, what how do you go about it, and also what inspires you xa ubhalayo?
Into endi-inspirishayo zintle, kukufuneka kube khona into endishisayo endiqondayo uba man le into andikwazi ungayinotice. Emna even i-everyday experiences and conversations, let's say ndikhwele mhlawumbi iteksi kuvele kubekho nje i-controversy eteksini, ndibe iphathi yayo ndi-engage ndincokole ntini. And then I feel like, bah, hi, man, ewe, sithethile, but ingathi asiyanga kulanda ifele ithole, yeyibona? So xa ndifike endlini le topic mandiyiqala ekuqaleni and ndizibuze into yokuba zeziphi izinto mhlawumbi izipices endinozifaka so that I can actually educate abantu, you know, and also entertain. I remember one time ndisuka eTinarha, sorry, emother when ndisiya eTinarha, kukho itshepi yayikhala phaa kula Avanza ndandiyikhwela. Wakhala lo mfo, wakhala and zange asixelele. But ndazixelela uba no, xa ndifika elibrary ngespet time sam mandilibhale eli bali. Jonga mandiakthe ngathi bendiyazi uba lo mfo bekwenzeke ntoni, bekutheni. Nangoku laphuma ibali lisithi yakhala indoda.
Yeah, that's beautiful. So, how long does it take for uba ubhale incwadi?
Kuyaxhomekeka nge-inspiration also nangamandla onawo, because ukubhala i-novel kokona kusokolisayo, but ukubhala i-short stories mna ndidla ngozinika ii-goals, ndizixela uba okay, ndizawubhala izitori eziyi-12, ndizawubhala izitori eziyi-15. Kuyaxhomekeka ngamandla endinawo. Iyakwazi uba ibe yi-6 months, iyakwazi uba ibe ngunyaka, kanti iyakwazi into yokuba in between la maxesha ndiwachaza.
And also xa ujongile kulutsha lwangoku, do you think that sinayo i-potential so that we can also be able to uba sibhale ezethu iincwadi?
Abantu abasebatsha abafana nawe zintle banayo kakhulu i-potential namhlanje. Ama-2000 ngabantu abanesibindi abakholwa ukuziveza izimvo zabo ukuthathatha esihlangalaleni, but I feel sometimes i-channel yabo okanye i-energy bayichannela kwindawo ezirongo. Ukubona, sometimes umntu uyakwazi uba nepoem nanko ifaka kwi-social network ethile, iyathathwa kukho umntu owenza imali ngalaa nto. So abantu I feel like uba ii-treasure zabo neziphiwo nezakhono zabo abazivezi ngendlela e-right, endaweni e-right, ngexesha eli-right. Otherwise i-potential ikhona. So I guess abantu abafana nam nabanye kufuneka be-educatile kulo mbandela.
So but siza as a youth, ne? For instance, mna ekhaya, they don't take indaba ye art seriously. Is it ubhala incwadi, is it something that can sustain one's life for the future as well?
Ubungaya phaa kwam andifuni uba ndiyaqhayisa kuba ndisetivini, ndingakhombela indawo ndithi le nale nale kungenxa yeencwadi zam ezizezinye zezincwadi. So urhulumente waseRhawutini especially i-library department under arts and culture bayakwazi uzithenga iincwadi zethu ngokusilapha e-Eastern Cape ngelishwa ke torhwane e-Eastern Cape. Oh, uyafaka ufake ebhishi ufake ibe yiloo nto, but akudeske kube khona nto ecaca yenzekayo. So siyakwazi into yokuba siphile ngokokubhala, but of course awunawuthi ungumntu uphile ngento enye. Kufana nento yoba uzawutya isonka nobiso kokoko okanye utya umvubo kokoko kuba usithi yi-favorite, funeka uzame uzifumanele nezinye iindlela zokuphila.
So also because see digital age ngoku, ne? Mhlambi I don't want a hard copy, I want a soft copy. Ihamba njani into yakhona? Is it better in hard copies or is it better in digital?
Kuxhomekeka kulo mntu uza kube efuna umsebenzi wam. If uyandixelela uba ndlakuse mna andinaxesha torhwana lobe ndiphethene nale ncwadi, awukwazi uba ube nayo online, siyakwazi ukumlungiselela abe ne-digital copy yakhe, even nendlela ayithenga ngayo ingadibani nam, ayithenge digitally. And amaxabiso ke ngoku ayehla, iba durenyana xa ilolu hlobo.
Xa ilolu hlobo. And also before we close off, I just want to know with indaba ye your collaborations and also some umntana who wants to start to write a book, ungamdirector in what direction?
Ubangaba ubukele ngoku ufuna ukubhala incwadi, andizumdirector kum xa engakhanga benento ayibhalileyo. Ndizamdirector kum only xa zikhona izinto azibhalileyo esithi ke ngoyebhuti ndibawulucetyisa uba from here yintoni endinokuyenza. Because ufumaniseka uba ngenxesha uyafowunela ngumntu andizubiza igama le ndawo. Molo bhuti, ndibhalile andiyazi noba yinovel noba yintoni le nto ndiyibhalileyo. So xa kutsho yena ke ngonam andizukwazi umbonisa uba oh yinto ethile. So ingaske nabantu abamngqongileyo like i-family members bamxelela uba wena unetalent ingaske ufuna abantu abanje nanje. So uyakwazi ukumdirector kumasango angawo. Noko andinamona nge-information as far as lo mcimbi because nam udibana nam kwabantu ndiye ndadibana nabo ndasebenza nabo at least noko izinto zam ziye zarayithi.
Yeah, and also abantu bangazifumana njani iincwadi zakho online stores sizifumana njani?
Iincwadi zam ziyafumaneka kum ezumadoda ndlakuse ko onke amakhasi onxibelelwano kanti ke njengoba ubuthetha nge-digital copies ikhona iwebhusayithi abantu abanokuyifumana kwakum enothi ndibanike yona bazikhangelela iincwadi zam not only ezizezam but nezabanye ababhala ababhala ngesixhosa nezabanye ababhala abhala ngesingesi ne-afrikaans njengoba bendikhe ndatsho.
Thank you so much, Phuthumadoda, for coming and also sharing a story, Sako. But right now, we have to close off this segment and lead you guys to an ad break. So I don't want you to go anywhere. Stay tuned because we're coming back.
Bafethu, welcome back to Channel 260, Channel of Choice. If you just joined us, you just got here at the perfect time. We have our first guest for the day. This is the June 16 edition. Utanzela mazetzet. Ulapha showini, Khulutmani, kunjani?
Mbuda, kunjani?
Siyaphila, Khulutmani. This is your moment to shine, Khulutmani. Cela ukuchazela abantu ababukele endlini uba ungubani, waphi, and wenzani wena.
Molweni kumpuma Kapa TV. You are watching Utanzela, Khulutmani Nice, Soloki Clean, Nephuma Eshumini. Yeah, Utanzela, artist. Creative to sum it up. Uphume Shumini yabo. Making music. Yeah, guys.
Tazela, Uphume Shumini, Shumini lamadoda okanye Shumi lokuyokuhlala e-Aryan. Seyibambileyo. Anyway, Tazela, xawusithi uyi-creative, yintoni i-creative Khulutmani from nongaziyo endlini, yintoni loo nto leyo?
Creative is someone who is creative in any way, like to be uyazoba, uyacula. There's a lot of creative things outside, like noba uyapeyinta, udlala ibhola, anything money that you create is you call yourself a creative. You're the creator, you guys.
Ingane hlobo uyibeka ngalo Tezela. Yazi undipha i-question bendingakhandilinde banzokubuza yona ngo-very soon. Tezela, xa usithi bana u-creative and then we also know bana we in a generation where as singaba silulutsha asisabenzi. Was it i-creativity yakho eqalela phana kulaa nto uba kusemani ndihlele lokushina khona ndiyenzayo ha mani mandizamele into ndibonezandisipanela ndizawukwazi ukwenza imali. Is that something lelo hlobo okanye kwenzeka ntoni?
No, le way yam started as kumamela abantu yabo. It's not like I created le way uba kuba ndifuna uphila ngayo.
Okay.
But yes, ixesha lihamba yaye ndafuna uphila ngayo because the way started as a hobby yabo and ke kumbisegazini because I was surrounded by amajita abhizi nomculo yabo nasikasi and then mamela umculo gqithi yabo. So yaba i-influence qombe ndaba i-influence ndiba yihama let me follow the way and then ke ngoku yasegazini and then ke ngoku even before mna ndibe yi-artist abantu bendibona as artist andiyazi uba why because bone xa mamela umculo mna kubone yirepa fethu qombe yaya ndiyarepa but I wasn't rapping but I was writing yabo. So phela ndiyifolowisha la ngxwambe yam mani iyandidlala ibona ngosinawo iyandidlala iyandidlala ya yabo ikandibuzi nje ne-hairstyle artist ya
sure
yinto ndiyifumana qho ke leyo yabo.
I love how you're enjoying your moments apha kumpuma Kapa TV and also let's talk about your trip. I see the trip was already on fire and uzixelele ubana namhlanje ndiza apha ndizothengisa mna. Let's put you on the spot, kwenzeke ntoni namhlanje?
Le trip bura yam it is made by out here phakum Eshumini.
Sure.
Gama uKhanyiso Miliwe.
Ah.
Apha kume
shout out to him. Shout out to him.
Snake creatives yabona. Inshayelelo linda jo bayekusemna nami.
Come again.
Khashayene man ngoba ekubeni benishayena kade yabo. Ishayinisa nayo but naye bese shayena. So yabona shining yadibana. So sawushayena so yithu yabo. It rip uMiliwe. Hairstyle ke. Nana Pomeri and Pom Pon for the night, and then Bindi Imki, Hotman and I, so solo he clean. Abo Hona was guy. Yeah.
Hotman, let's talk about your career, like the way it started. As Umsakalo say, as well, he creative as a pie, they always complain they have to leave the city by my going down. Let's talk about your journey, Inja and Apipai, when as Umukale up and then Ukunda Uku and Amshanj.
Yeah, Pura, I can say the creativity, we are Chalap. We are struggling, but. Goku, as a matter of share, Amba, I think it's soft. It depends, ba, Uama no ban. Because Amanyamanji, there's about each of Nega Pume to make it, and that's true. Upper young in the corner, and Von Shai, young in the corner. Kind only, we like his support from a band of Salanab.
Sure.
A band to Salanab, so the support for Struggleish, and Genya, no, and most of the things and doing, sends and doing. No power, but forgetting about who's the power, need that one.
Sure.
Yeah, well, so now I can say Tina Solo was calling and doing until the store fell away, you pull my pants, be laps, supportan, guys, because I support to be honest. Supportan, even though the girl, like last month, then show him at his work, the number of Kimber Chrome on the neck.
Yeah,
but I'm by the second installation. I'll call you by the small numbers. Yeah, cool.
Sure.
And then you get born once you went the indoor prof, a gas. I'm not saying a lap hands. Because what I can say, because calling each other people, now be Zambia and Jebuke. I want my bacalas and the charging fee. Yeah, for you. The way I have fun, you are 60 rand, it would be 60 rand doing it. I can't, you are no be 20 rand. I was a hot man. The hot man was loom.
Sure, your pangel.
Beside Londo, yeah, 20 rand is cut sack.
Sure, same man.
Was a moon like Nango say 20 rand. I call it 20 rand up. But yeah, it was 60 rand. Nanny and Spanana. He called by you, I tore 60 rand. No man, see Cupelo Ole, no Mr. Taylor on Barren. There's a week in
the kitchen.
I chose Kankang, Eleman. I'm a castle in the middle of the world. I'm a castle in the middle of the world.
A product on Ayo, and also Kukabani Banga Yazila, but we also engineer. Let's talk about that. Like, decide about how you may engineer and then push him through Okanya Kunzaganja, Chakisha goes away to Kunzaganon.
Yeah, poor I am. Yeah, at your lap, as Babu Buzil. Yeah, you need that away. You're about with support.
Sure.
So, Yakele is almost business with his boss. So, the at your move, if you're going to touch my good talent, he's funny. So, because I come and support die. Like even for when Steven Yam have to pop up in Malayam to make to rent the sound, then they and everything man is all need take apart. So yeah, bo actually I may need to support. Yeah, so they support in other ways.
Basically he's saying that guys, he's funding his own future because I come them support our years fan of Tata Malukolinikala, I sing up. Which is good rough, guys. And I also said in the sharp player Khrutman was funding Ukwako. Let's talk about Khrutman Kulowam. June 16. Siyazi ndwe June 16 injani. And it was the youth of 1976 that bachinja ikhasi ne. And then when after le munyaka le ndes chikas chekisha namhlanje as a youth yaka 2024. Khrutman, what you would say about that was good, that was bad, okanye asinambulelo.
Yeah, I had to pay the lead. Because I can say sinambulelo, but it's so serious again, really wrong.
Sure.
Because I wanna get a clash on Zim. But nangoku second zima because the queen is getting lilayo to improve our country to party as it's seven years.
Sure.
Such a song about Hill, Abashala going down with the crane. They figure a leg cast with the crane. But he cast once once is always the grand. So I say, I have Pamba and a little Pamban is because a cast as it's Kelang with the crane, as his bonus and gay with the crane. How is it different cast? Bangati, Manel. So as number, but if you can go like you touch out the second is up the morning space, so I can say future the way
that's right.
Yeah, like generation.
Sure.
If you know consideration because yeah, chance yeah, you that's really a question. Like this Chinese land, generation because kukhi chances zingekho ngoku ya.
Sure.
So they have to buy grab la opportunity because abantu abakhulu zabayifumana opportunity yabo. So they have to baba followishe ba grab la way kube grand man country ngoku.
Like umzekelo, like giving you a chance like umzekelo for a day. So kwenze as mayor for a day. What improvement ungazuba uyibona ekhasi lakho?
Ikhasi lami. Yo, for a day, and sending a whole man the
car. Sure. It's a technical and a mini, but I say, I can shine a cousin like one year, yes, but Basuka Palmas looks like what is happening. So we say, now we're just going to give you a day, but I say, improving, really improvement about what was born when it comes to
the car. Caslam, I know Tim Malls is called.
Mm-hmm.
And man, changing all those band, Carlaman, before we change a cast. A band by a school issue. Bonnie, but far away, long on the back say, who's the cast lako, living swim of no car change away?
Sure.
Because I know how to change the cast because I'm going to slow you. No car by source, a land and knowledge about that. Once the cast in the change. Once you change away, it was a wild change cast. That's the only thing I change a caliber before I change the cast. Because the cast, the business of a whole man. I'm not sure.
Social media, where can they get you? And Skalinde Landoni, anytime soon?
Okay, before say with social media, he's a track, and the Cooper is produced by Uvi Prince, producer. It is called Pisgo Line, because you can see in the Pisgo Line. And also, Koda Nenyazayo, I'm planning to release three tracks on Yaka, and then Tom Chance. Also is produced by Elephant Beats. And then your name is Tonga Bech and Damano AC. Also is produced by V Prince. Yeah, and then your next day, I'm banning EPM and the beat on the AC.
Welcome back to channel 260, channel of choice. If you just joined us, the name of the show, The Hangout. My friend to Saku, welcome friend to Tuage, Buile, no Putloid. Putloid is one of our fitness trainers, a lapper in Nelson Mandela Bay, but he's going to tell us about himself. Kotman Kunjan.
Siyaphila mndakwethu akho ndo kunja.
Ah, siyaphila mkhulu wami. Cela uchazele ababukeli abantu babukela endlini bawubhuti ngubani, ngowaphi yena, kwenza ntoni?
Sizothi ubhuti ngusonezo Gobelani. Uzalelwe kwela mhlaba wasehluleka engqeleni ngokuhlala nisemathawel so ndikwicala le fitness trainer instructor so I'm also a bodybuilder bro.
Let's talk about Leno Leo Rodman being a fitness trainer. Like we all know ukhula sikhule ku generation bana ezinye izinto bese zenzi ne lesilando lamana uya esikolweni ubuye ufunde xa ugqibela ufunda afuna kube ugqirha beli police beli traffic nozile hlobo. But when we hear what you said about man, that's only the time there's no influence. Each challenge is there, doesn't you have a
Sizothi being a colula, being a colula, remember Umzimba Yongel and Dogagai. So that is why ngathi the first 3 days here in Zimba Kakulu, because Umzimba Babana Makrems, so when this in Donga Kailanga, and no Lwazi, Klausa Figa, Yonando Esesokolisai.
Let's talk about lento le ngiqhubo ithetha Holman bana umzima bengakayiqhele. Like umzekelo umnamwana fa babantu babhadala i-gym danga bahamba. Dimango ngokuya xa siva zaphenga maala man. Ayindimi lona man. Xa liphathe iglass uvela khona ey kubhlungu ingalweni. Let's talk about lento leyo Holman, the challenges because we see a lot of zinitsi kuthiwa zi drop out e-gym. Lento leyo zinjinjalo lento le.
Esothini mna umuntu ofikayo ozo trainer nami ndiyamxelela straight ndijonga the first 3 days izoba nzima sometimes the whole week izoba nzima but unyamezele umzimba sube usaqala uadjusta kwi challenge entsha sube uqala into ongayiqhelanga the moment umzimba uyiqhela lanto ayisavakali laphi
also umzekelo khona kukho into yenzekayo lelo whereas you trying to get umzimba right ne marke ngoku bekho lanto bana asinemali endlini yabo ino into yenzekayo ndizawutyela nikhiwayo endlini yabo and then can ndive xa sincokola itsho mzama vele athi omnye ba hayi mani into yenzekayo funeka ube ne-diet elehlobo ne-diet elehlobo kwenzeka njani like umzimba umna ndinalo umzimba ungako anayo imali yothenga ezi diet zi-fancy but nebawela bayi-bodybuilder ngenza njani kwezo situation
idayethi ndizothini bathi abantu idayethi is expensive but kum isimple eyam idayethi isimple ischicken le uyithenga ithengwayo endlini ne-rice le ithengwayo endlini neveg is just that indlela oyenza ngakhona so instead of adding ilento i oil labo sunflower abanye basebenzisa i olive oil but mna don't use oil at all that's qhelisa lana ba ekugeni kwami andikufaki oil
so i oil ungayifaki
oil lengayifakiyo then ne starch ndisicuthe
as a tikandi yazi leyo into lawe but you just school me about something new but let's talk about like umzekelo futhi uqalile as a fitness trainer and then there are challenges and then sometimes you don't get sponsors like yonke into ufuna ukuyenza ngokwakho mhlawumbe umzekelo uthi we-gym kuyavalwa ngexesha oluthile and then ke ngokwakwazi ukuoperate whereas you have clients ezifuna ukuya ezo challenges into enjani ngoku
sizothi kuhlala kukhona izinto ekuthiwa zi-alternative lapho ungakwa kunama-workouts mntakwethu ekuthiwa zi-free weight workout lapho ukwazi ukutraina umlenze utraine ingalo yakho kungekho equipment wenza ama-free weight squats for ukwenza imilenze kungekho equipment yenzeka
uhlele qhingini kahle kahle so lokuhlala uhlala unayo iplan
uhlala uneplan
I like that for man let's talk about it man lendo enduni kola sileyo about how much it touch mayo most of the most bona as two sensitivity elections is gore most of bona ba they always humble yendwendula neyinto yobala xa usejimi kuvela ukuthiwa bayi ba humble because umna I personally feel mina if ever knows on gym angavela ngileyana xa direction bona but you guys are so humble enough
Eh nizothini mntakwethu into yokuqala esicelelwayo okanye sicelelana ngayo sitijonga ke mntakwethu lento iqalayo ke ngoku sesinye nje istage esehlukileyo kulo life obeuphila ngathi usuqala ulife omtsha the moment umzimba wakho udevelopa uba mkhulu abantu sebekubona ngelinye imehlo bale isejimela ukubetha abantu so suka kulo mentality so ufuneka nezinto ezingathi ziyalwisa uhlala uzi avoid if uyabona ukuthi okay apha ndiya provokeka uzi distance
hey ayi ngeke mfethu I thought about the gym intimate ubetha abantu kanti then you just building umzimba wakho but let's talk about also into eyenzekayo kwamajita akhulayo adlala rugby as high school nala mashita ku rugby club kwi club ne one thing I realized as growing up ne kukho lento bekuthiwa steroids ne blue pills amajita tshelando and then once bayeke ujima uvela ubona umjita umzimba uyahla bengathi uyagula what would you advise umjita okhulayo omncinci endlini osisebenzisa isteroids is it a good thing or is it bad
ndizoba honest mntakwethu it's not a good it's bad mna I always advise abantu ukuthi mawutrainer especially mawutrainer nami if usebenzisa isteroid sikumoshe then uzongcolisa igama lami so ndingathi mna stick ekutyeni kukhona ama-tablets athengwa koma-pharmacy nakoma-clicks o-discam anazo ezi zinto i-steroid abantu basebenzisa just because bafuna quick results abafuna ukutraina for ixesha elide umzekelo mna ndingakuxelela okay I'll be honest I've been training for 7 years bra like 7 years ndanimngakangawe ndingatsho but for 7 years angazi ndaphosa inyanga neyi-one ndi-trainer for 7 years so i-most abantu babalekela kwi-steroid just because ufuna uba kulonyaka afuna ukuritsha lo mzimba umzekelo lo mzimba wami kulonyaka aqale ngawe then ba overdose izinto zibonza kalisi so mina ngathi steroid asikho right
ake if you using steroids yeah ke ngusayiqala mshana and also uthi waqala ngangami so nami also motivated mhlawumbe one day ngangayi ba noma serious no gym but anyway let's talk about it because I still remember kwakukhona onobuhle bensimbi ezazinto still remember kasi ezazinto zokufika we go out i-competition have you ever been part of it competition
siqale ishow yami yokuqala ye-bodybuilding yayingo June 2019 yes eyokugqibela be last year ngo September IFBB SA eMpumalanga lapho ndaphuma number 1 da select ukuthi team efuneka iye eSpain yomela umzansi
sure let's stay on the first one you said the first one is back in 2019 and then after leyo qala I think you had a good result so decided ba mokuqhubekeke nayo and then you saying now eyokugqibela be leya last year masiqala kuleyo qala kwazi yayinjani the first experience
ndizothi kukhona utata mntakwethu kuthiwa ngutata uGoodman Gqoma wase Motherwell NU8 la tata nguye owandithatha estradweni wandisa ejimini wandi trainer naye wandifundisa indlela yotya even kwishow yami yokuqala labhatalelwa nguye ndasiwa nguye waze wathi naye wayeseretirelini but wathi uzobuya for ukubonisa nokuthi kumele ndenze wa computer then nda computer nami so wayenza lula
eish nyana lekwabukhona nyana abantu balelo hlobo bomini where as they will literally take you from a location because they see the potential let's state lena ya last year khulumane uthe uyiphumelisa and you were on the team that was selected to go and represent South Africa outside the SA let's talk about that why was it the last show yakho
nizothini mntakwethu kulonyaka ndi decide ukuthi okay nizothatha ibreak because ngifuna ukuchintsha ne ufuna ukubuya ndi challenge so meaning ngizothatha ibreak ndibhalke for ubamkhulu then ichinjele kwi stage sabantu abakhulu kunalo mzimbeni kuwe
sure
so yonke lanto need ubandi bene break ezawubandanya so that's why ndathi last year ithatha ishow yokugqibela
my love lenitita roma so basically it's like taking a break whereas you're going to push harder ngakala
yes.
So it's like uyo gym awugqibanga
yes and ivalanga incwadi
oh futhi besifuna luxa nje leyo plan iphindo koma bukile bit but anyway gents kusekuningi ozayo but iphuthi samphanje umzuzu asichazele basingamfumana naphi kwi social media before la sam supportela matyala wethu social media roma sangafumana naphi
ukhona ku Instagram as Lloyd Gobelane. Ukhona ku Facebook as Lloyd Gobelane. Ukhona na ku TikTok as Lloyd Gobelane.
Afethu nimvile we're to get him on social media platform Tinasia Bulela for thank you. Tinasia Bulela ngokuhlala nathi nibukele le show and also ku Lloyd siyabulela kakhulu ngexesha lakho mkhulu wami. Khathi sithi sishelele thina sobhatala matyala we'll come back after this.
Yeah, inkosi.
Bafethu, welcome back to Channel T60, Channel of Choice. If you just joined us, I can be late, but we're still on it, man. Yes, Bafethu, this is the June 16 edition, and we decided to go out and sing ngokulo nolutsha silvebalithini bona. But again, we're going to change our TV, kabukele uve ubathini bona. We will come back after this.
Once I've graduated, I feel like I have to leave the country. It's nothing personal, it's just it's a money thing because our country is struggling financially and with all the corruption I don't see like how it moves, you know.
One of the changes or the main changes that I would like to see in South Africa is the leadership, which is I would like to see more youth in parliament, I would like to see more youth in jobs. Because as it is here in South Africa now, there are old people and we need new innovative ideas from the young people. What happens is that after the young people go out of university, you find out there is scarcity of jobs. So that is one of the main things that I would like to see change here in South Africa.
The changes that I would like to see in the country is the involvement of political leaders into our country and being able to put in the services that society needs, because all of us are Africans who seek for a better future. So if political leaders can make sure they also pay attention to South African citizens and actually satisfy us in that way.
I feel like as youth we should just unite and not be shy of expressing our ideas and all that.
Would I leave or stay in this country after I graduate? So I feel like I would leave, as much as I want, you know, to have a home in South Africa, and like also my safety is not guaranteed for us to understand less opportunities. Yes, we do have some opportunities, but I feel like out there there will be better opportunities and not have like a broad perspective of everything else compared to when I'm here in South Africa.
The changes I would like to see in the country is substance abuse. It's taken very lightly, because you find that you have white collar drugs and then you have the drugs that are flooding our communities. So if they would actually come up with like programs to actually talk to these fellas or women who are taking these drugs to see where they're coming from, and then you know, check their background, you can see the lot of causes of substance abuse.
I feel like the youth should be more involved in governing the country, because we live in it first and foremost, and I feel like we're too relaxed. Yes, we are studying and trying to better our futures, but I feel like we're not in governing the country. We're just in the country to just enjoy and, you know, study, but we're not governing it. And I feel like we have more perspective, we have more knowledge on most things.
Yes, I feel like more youth should be, in the sense that I think we have different ideas to how we would like to see change in our country. And I think we have effective ways of implementing that.
When I've graduated, I want to leave the country, because honestly, you know, like at this point, I don't see myself succeeding in a country like this. You know, yeah, I have like a lot of ambitions and goals, and I don't see myself completing those goals and ambitions in a country like this.
The changes I would like to see in South Africa is like we should like give us youth the chance to express our opinions in the country, you know. Like we understand that people that are in high places experience like the apartheid, the pain, the suffering. Yeah, we understand Nelson Mandela went to prison, like yeah, it's nice. Yeah, and we are grateful for that. But now we need the chance. We need the chance to express our opinion and show the world what we know. You know, like some of us are just staying at home with what we have, and it's like we can express it and like show the world what we have. Like, and take a safe far.
The uncertainties I have for the future are probably my ability to like continue managing what I have. I know it's pretty difficult to just get the bare minimum nowadays with inflation and all that, and the rand is not getting any stronger, so that's probably my biggest concern, which is probably holding me back and encouraging me kind of to leave the country. But yeah, in terms of other uncertainties, just making sure that the government and the future of South Africa is good, that's also another thing for me. Just making sure that we have the right people in power who include the youth in their plans, include God in their plans, and ensure that everybody of all races, all genders, all of everything is involved in the future of the country.
Mavethu, welcome back to Channel 260, Channel of Choice. Mavethu, uvavile mosibathini esikratweni, uvile ulutsha luthini. I hope ukhona okufundileyo, ukhona okuthakuthileyo waqhubeka against panel. Zinhle?
Yeah.
What's happening, girl?
So what's happening is just I'm giving people a little brief of what 1976, June 16, is all about. So it's basically a youth day to commemorate students, as I said, Soweto, who stood against the Bantu education, and they fought. They're like, no man, Africans are your language that we're supposed to be using in schools, and let's rather use a generic language to study. And also Youth Day was initially known as the Soweto Day among supporters of your political parties such as your ANC, but officially it made public holiday after Nelson Mandela became the president in 1994. Mm. So the government at that time then chose to call it a youth day to commemorate the role of the youth that they played in overcoming the apartheid regime. Mm. So we also have people like Abu Hector Peterson that we got to learn about in school. So there were also the students that fought then, and unfortunately for him, he had to lose his life during that fighting. And yeah, man, a youth day is basically to celebrate in South Africa, and as a day of the June 16, because that's when the whole event started to happen. So yeah, that is it, June 16. And also, Lwando, what I want to know from you as a youth, yanamhlanje, what are you fighting for?
To be honest with you, I think umlandlwela noni lola lendo mana kukho I graduates ezingaphangeliyo. And if you still remember back in the days, they used to say that go to school, ube graduate, and then you're going to get jobs. Got it. All to find out now, bachinje is deep.
Yeah, yeah.
So you have to fight for those things, because you tend to look more go I graduate, we have money, I kill nje, look shady, ingen zinik. So that's the problem we have. And I also want to ask you something. Kau siti bana babelwela. Do you think, Bana, if ever Besteta song language won school in Beso Bakran?
Well, it was not going to be fair, especially to people like us who are Africans, who are supposed to also be given the platform so that Sikwazi was express I and also teach other people gay languages there too. Because if ever that fight or that protest did not happen that year, and be proud in speaking isiXhosa. Yes, I don't speak isiXhosa 100%, but siyazama. So yeah, that's also a privilege that we managed to get. So I won't be here.
Yes, to be honest with you, I don't have a problem with that, because I understand that people were fed up by Africans. But yeah, if you notice other countries, language one and they all get along and back then they both. So that's another thing coming in this booze. But man, if ever go on the kill and they didn't break us, and come breaking all makes a sharp one. And also, I want to state something, man, the civil titan and about the boundary education.
Yeah, yeah,
let's talk on that. What's the change after 1976 youth?
Well, now personally, when I did my own research, what I noticed is that we are more lenient than they were. Because, for instance, if Sijonga with indaba ye percentage, for them, it was like 50% and up. If you have something less than 50, then that's fail. But to us, at least we're getting a 30% of a pass rate. You must at least get 30%. So that's the difference. I feel like Tina Simo chilled ngoku siyasa laid back, you get. Yeah.
Get you. And also, yes, one thing I realized about us as the youth of 2024, we don't have unity.
Yeah.
Because you can remember that those students, it was a school from Misoweto, they started, it was like, no man, Makmiwe, Safunda. And then the other school Nazo, they were like, no man, Abanye Benza Lena and Natmasins. So that's one thing I noticed, but unity is something that we don't have. Tina yes, that's one thing like in. Like, what, how do you see that? Like, because I feel like Satata is in the Palena, the main core, it was unity. Because he Waba Unite and Bakren. And then youth of 2024-ish.
See, all I can say is that Silulu Cholunginam Golo. To be honest, Silulu Cholunginam Golo. Because for instance, right now, Sisando Puma on elections,
sure,
we were supposed to fight and voice out so that we can be able to bring the change as Sisoloko Sitetangayo on the social media. So it's basically us, we need to unite as the youth and also make sure uba si nomqolo. That's all I can say. Yeah.
Nah, but I mean, I always look at us as this generation, but we're scared of change. That's how I see it. Because if ever we were bold enough, we were going to be that generation. And so like, okay, you know what? Say, as bakukumbutu tila August kalangayo, but to give ngoku, let's try lombutu. Because I feel like we also do have power. Like, we're going to give you 5 years, and then after that, we're going to come back. And they're like, no, man. Because now alone was the same thing.
Yeah.
Zinhle singabantu aba social media, and kuthi namhlanje we literally like in 2016 we're just enjoying the fact that asiphangeli. What's the thing like a CNSI with June 16, no? Besides Ukhlalanje?
So June 16, it's to make sure that you are informed and also you get to inform the younger generation so that we don't get to lose the culture of the day and also we don't get to lose to understand its main concept and also its main impact in our lives, especially as the youth of South Africa. So Lwando, with that being said, mm-hmm. we have to close off this segment mm-hmm. and we have to love and leave our people. So on the screens, how can you say people can get hold of you?
Now to get hold of me, man, you can get me on social media, Lwando Njokweni on Facebook, and then Instagram, Lwando Njokweni, man. I don't have a Twitter. I'm on TikTok. I'm just there.
Yeah.
I'm just there. It's also Lwando Njokweni. I don't have Magwatini. When does the we get you?
So mna, I am basically Unhlenhle _ N on all social media platforms. And then on Facebook, it is Uzinhle Ngcazamayeba. But yeah, you can communicate with me and hit us up also onto the Mpuma Kapa TV station socials. It is at Mpuma Kapa TV. And they can do what?
Mm-hmm. You can hit us up any given time if you want us to cover your event or anything you want us to do for you, man. You can hit us up.
Yeah.
Private. But if you're not hanging with us, we're just out like that.